this is going to be an unusual quick book review of mine. I have just completed The Machine Gunners by Robert Westall, and I imagine if you're in the UK, you may know it. If you're overseas, you may not. I think this is probably a niche book review, but I recently attended the Imperial War Museum in Duxford, and whilst there, I saw this for sale in their souvenir shop, their gift shop, the 40th anniversary edition, and something went off in my brain. As usual, it was out of nowhere, couldn't quite place it, but I knew this book. I knew the title, and I knew certain parts of the plot as stuff advanced. So I picked it up, and I've gone headfirst into it quite quickly on my TBR, skipped a lot of stuff, went straight into this. And the old memories, these are some of the oldest memories that my 37-year-old brain can recall. Like, I read this, and what I thought I knew, I did know, and the things I didn't know sometimes shocked me about this book. This is a book set during World War II. You may have been able to guess that from the cover there. And it follows a boy entering his early teenage years, I think it is. A boy called Chaz. Well, it follows lots of different boys. It becomes like a little gang, and a girl too, all in this one little gang. And the whole plot revolves around the boy is, he goes out and he seeks souvenirs from bits of plane that have been shot off, and you know, bits of bomb and all this kind of different stuff. Look, World War II war souvenirs. And he's got a collection. And then one day, against the odds, I think, he finds the tail section of a German bomber plane that came down the night before. And in the tail section is a tail gun, which he spirits away in his own special way, and hides. And there's certain parts of this that I really think I should have remembered, and I just didn't. Like, when he finds the machine gun, the machine gunner in the tail section is dead next to the gun, and it's described, this dead German soldier is described in quite gruesome detail sometimes. And again, there's things in this book which I honestly can't remember a lot of, but there's a fight between two boys at school, and it is kind of horrifically brutal. Like, one of the boys very nearly dies, and you're like, I'm surprised that that didn't leave a memory. But what can it say? It probably says more about me that in my mind I could remember the machine gunners as something that revolved around the gun, which is very much, I think, the child's perspective, and the reason it's called the machine gunners. But there was other stuff happening that was surprisingly adult and sinister. And like, there's things that happen in here, like, there's effectively it's torture. I mean, I think he refers to it as torture, but it's torture. Like, one lad to another, one boy to another, bullying, but I mean, excessive even for bullying. Like, it's out and out torture. And I couldn't remember any of that, so in I went to the machine gunners with these faint memories that I thought I could remember. And it turns out I very much could, but the reread of this book that is such a far distant memory for me, I can't remember hardly anything about how I consumed it originally. Did I read it? I wasn't much for reading books in my younger years. I really wasn't. Yet I have the distinct feeling, not memory, but feeling that it was a book. Did someone read it to me? That doesn't really ring any bells for whatever reason. It's not a small book, and I don't see my younger self reading it, but I just don't know how I consumed this book in the original form. I don't think there's a TV show or movie or whatever about machine gunners. I wouldn't be surprised if there is at this point, but I don't think I've ever seen it. Yeah, it was a little mystery as to how I first originally consumed the machine gunners. It's not in any way a disappointing read if you go in from scratch. It's just a fascinating tale set around a place called Garmouth, which is not Garmouth in Scotland, but a fictional Garmouth somewhere in the north of England that was used by the author. And this 40th edition is quite handy. It's got a little interview section at the back with the author, and then rather bizarrely to me, there's also a kind of follow-on tale, which is a prequel, about the same lad who's like the front and centre of this book, and it's about ghosts for some reason. So I don't really care to follow up with a ghostly tale connected to something that was very real in World War II. And I think if you're looking for a young person to read something about an experience of World War II, I think The Machine Gunners is probably the best choice that I've come across so far. Because otherwise I've just been reading factual books like, you know, war journals and this, that and the other, which children aren't really going to be into. So this really works, I think. But as a caveat, it is quite brutal sometimes. The descriptions of the dead, the bullying, the fights, the stuff that goes on, just generally speaking. And in one way, you're sheltered because you're in it from the boy's point of view. So it's not like you know the true horrors of war. But on the other hand, the children have a unique situation where they don't really trust the adults, because the adults don't seem to know what they're doing, so the children kind of do their own thing. But anyway, The Machine Gunners, a World War II book which has ghostly memories for me. And even after a reread, I really enjoyed it. I really did. It was fascinating to go back through and to find the pieces that I could remember, and those things that I just had no idea were coming. I think this is a really good book. So if you're inclined to read something about the children during World War II in the northeast of England, I think Robert Westall's The Machine Gunners is a really good book. And that's it, folks. That's all I got. Farewell.